إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره، ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه ومختاره من خلقه وخليله. أشهد أنه بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة، وكشف الله جل وعلا به الغمة، تركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. صلوات الله وتسليماته وتبريكاته عليه وعلى أهل بيته. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، لكل إنسان في هذه الحياة أمان كثيرة ومتعددة. In this life, every human being has many and different wishes. فلو سألت إنسانا ما أمنيتك في هذه الحياة؟ If you were to ask a human being, what is your wish in this life? فإن كان من وسط فقير وعاين الفقر وأحس بألمه لتمنى أن يعيش غنيا وليعيش منعما. If this human being came from a background of poverty and has seen poverty and experienced the pain of being without, his wish would be to get rich and to live a good and a comfortable life. ولو قابلت مريضا طرحه المرض على الفراش فشل حركته وقيد حريته. If you came across a sick person on a hospital bed and asked them, what is your wish? And with the knowledge that this sickness has immobilized them, denied them even the freedom to move, ومنعه حتى من لذة الطعام والمنام. The sickness has deprived them of the taste of food and the comfort of sleep. وسألته ما أمنيتك. If you were to ask this person, what is your wish? لرأيته أن يتمنى أن يعافى من مرضه ولو افتدى بماله كله. His only wish would be to get cured, even if it means they sacrifice all of their wealth. ولو سألت طالبا جامعيا عن أمنيته. If you were to ask a university student, what is your wish? لرأيته يتمنى وظيفة مرموقة تكفيه. His wish is to have a good job that would take care of his needs. وزوجة حسناء تغريه. And a beautiful wife. ومنزلا واسعا يؤويه. And to live in a big house. ولو سألت بعض الأغنياء عن أمنياتهم. If you were to ask the wealthy about their wish, لرأيتهم يتمنون مزيدا من الغنى ليكونوا أغنى من فلان وعلان. And their wish would be to get even wealthier so that they can have more wealth than so and so. وهكذا فالمقل لا يقنع. And so therefore, the one who has little will never be satisfied. والمكثر لا يشبع. And the one who has in plenty will never be satisfied. وأماني الدنيا لا تنتهي. And the wishes of this life will never come to an end. وصدق رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حينما قال. And the messenger of Allah, he spoke the truth when he said, لو أن لابن آدم واديا من ذهب أحب أن يكون له واديان. If the son of Adam, if the human being, and this is hypothetical, if the son of Adam had a valley filled with gold, they would wish to have an extra one. أحب أن يكون له واديان ولن يملأ فاه إلا التراب. And nothing will kill their desires, will bring it to an end, except the dirt of their grave. أي لا يزال ابن آدم حريصا على الدنيا حتى يموت ويمتلئ جوفه من تراب قبره. The human being will always be desirous of this dunya until they die and they get lowered in their graves and they are covered by the dirt of the grave. ومع هذه الأمان المتباينة, and with all the different wishes, فإن الجميع تراهم يسعون ويقدحون طوال حياتهم لتحويل أحلامهم وأمنياتهم إلى واقع. And you will see everyone striving and slaving in order to turn their dreams and their wishes into reality. ولكن هناك فئة من الناس. However, there is a group of people لا يمكنهم تحقيق أمنياتهم. They can never be able to realize their wishes. ولا ينظر في طلباتهم. And nobody looks into their needs. فمن هم؟ So who are these? هذا ما سنعرفه في هذه الخطبة. This is what we will discover in this خطبة. أما عن هذه الفئة. As for this group of people التي لا يمكنها تحقيق أمنياتهم. This group of people that will never be able to realize their wishes. فهم ممن أصبحوا رهائن ذنوب لا يطلقون. These have become prisoners of their sins and they will never be set free. وغرباء سفر لا ينتظرون. Strangers on a journey and yet nobody awaits their return. إنهم الأموات يا عباد الله. These are the dead people. فماذا يتمنى الأموات يا ترى؟ What is it that the dead people wish for? وقد انقطع عنا خبرهم. We have no communication with them. واندرس ذكرهم. And their memory has been wiped out. ومن يا ترى يستطيع أن يحدثنا عن أمنياتهم؟ And who is this that can tell us what their wishes are? تعالوا لنتحدث قليلا عن هذه الفئة المنسية. Come let us talk about this group of people that has been forgotten. لنعرف أمنيات أناس. That we may find out what are the wishes of a people بعد أن عاينوا الجنة والنار. After they have seen paradise and hellfire. ورأوا ملائكة الله. And they saw the angels of Allah. وأصبح الغيب لديهم شهادة. And the unseen has become too clear for them. وأيقنوا في برزخهم. And now they know in this life of barzakh أنهم سيبعثون ليوم النشور. They are now certain that they will be resurrected on the day of resurrection. فلنسمع ما نقله لنا كتاب ربنا وسنة نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عن أمنيات الموتى. Let us see what the book of Allah and the sunnah of the beloved messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, what they have to tell us about the wishes of the dead. أولا, first, يتمنى الميت لو تعاد له الحياة ليصلي ولو ركعتين. The dead person wishes if life would be restored back to them so that they can pray two rak'ah. فقد روى أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم مر بقبر فقال أبو هريرة, may Allah be pleased with him. He narrates that one day the Messenger of Allah, he passed by a grave and he said, من صاحب هذا القبر? Who is the companion of this grave? فقالوا فلان. And they said his name. فقال, and so he said, ركعتان أحب إلى هذا من بقية دنياكم. Two rak'ah is more beloved to this person than your whole world. رواه الطبراني وصححه الألباني. وفي رواية قال, in a different version he said, ركعتان خفيفتان. Two rak'ah that is very light. مما تحقرون, that you would look down upon. وتنفنون, that you would pray as an optional prayer. يزيدها هذا في عملي, that this person would be able to add to his deeds. أحب إليه من بقية دنياكم, is more beloved to this person in the grave than your whole world. فغاية أمنية الميت. And so the greatest wish of a dead person, أن يمد له في أجله. If only Allah would give them another chance, ليركع ركعتين, so that they can pray two rak'ah. يزيدها فيها من حسناته, so that he can add on to his good deeds. ألم تسمعوا وصية رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول لنا معشر الأحياء? Did you not hear the advice that the beloved messenger he gave to us, the people who are alive, when he said, الصلاة خير موضوع. Prayer is the best of deeds. فمن استطاع أن يستكثر فليكثر. The one who wants, the one who's able to do it in plenty, he should do so. لقد عاين ذلك الميت وهو في قبره ثواب الصلاة. This dead person in his grave has seen the rewards of salah. وَرَأَى بِأُمِّ عَيْنِهِ فَائِدَةَ الصَّلَاةِ. He has seen the benefit of salah in the grave. فَتَأَسَّفَ عَلَىٰ أَيَّامٍ أَمْضَاهَ فِي غَيْرِ طَاعَةٍ. And now this person is remorseful, is regretful over days that went by without salah. لا يريد من الدنيا إلا ركعتين. That is all that he wants from this life, to just pray two rak'ah. وماذا تساوي الدنيا عنده وقد خلفها وراء ظهره وارتهن بعمله. And what would be the value of this life, this world, and he has left everything behind and now is a prisoner of his deeds inside his grave. أما نحن أهل الدنيا. So ask the people who are still alive. فَمُفَرِّطُونَ فِي أَوْقَاتِنَا. We misuse our time. بَلْ فِي حَيَاتِنَا. We misuse this gift of life that Allah has given us. نَبْحَثْ عَمَّا يَقْتُلْ أَوْقَاتَنَا. We're looking for what will kill our time. وَمِنَّا مَنْ يَقْطَعُهَا بِالْمَعَاصِي. And yet others, they spend this life in committing sins. أما الأمنية الثانية, as for the second wish, التي يتمناها الموتى, that the dead people wish for, فهو الرجوع إلى الدنيا. It is to come back to this life, ولو لدقائق معدودة, even if it be for a few moments, ليتصدقوا, that they may give in charity. ليقدموا صدقة لله, to give charity for the sake of Allah. ولقد نقل الله لنا أمنيتهم هذه في قوله. And Allah has relayed this wish when he said, وأنفقوا مما رزقناكم من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت فيقول ربي لولا أخرتني إلى أجل قريب فأصدق وأكن من الصالحين. And spend in charity of that which we have provided you before death comes to one of you. And he says, my Lord, if only you would give me respite for a little, then I should give sadaqah and be among the righteous. And the answer, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا وَاللَّهُ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. The answer will always be a no. Allah will never give a person another chance. لَقَدْ اِقْتَنَعُوا. The dead people are convinced. وَلَكِنْ بَعْدَ فَوَاتِ الْأَوَانِ. But now it is too late. أَنَّ الصَّدَقَة, that giving in charity, مِنْ أَحَبِّ الْأَعْمَالِ إِلَى اللَّهِ, is one of the most beloved deeds to Allah. وَأَنَّ الْعَبْدِ, and that the servant, سَيُسْأَلُ عَنْ مَالِهِ, will be questioned about his wealth. مِنْ أَيْنَ اكْتَسَبَهُ وَفِيمَا أَنْفَقَهُ, how did you earn this wealth and how did you spend it? أَمَّا الْأُمْنِيَةُ الثَّالِثَةَ الَّتِي يَتَمَنَّاهَا الْمَوْتَى, as for the third wish that the dead people wish for, فَهِيَ الْعَوْدَةُ إِلَى الدُّنْيَا لِيَكُونُوا صَالِحِينَ, is that if only they could come back to this life so that they can be good people, righteous people. لِيَعْمَلُوا أَيَّ عَمَلٍ صَالِحٍ, that they may be able to do any righteous deed. لِيَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ تَعَالَى وَلَوْ مَرَّةٍ, that they be able to remember Allah even once. يَتَمَنَّوْنَ النُّطْقَ بِالتَّسْبِيحَ وَلَوْ بِتَسْبِيحَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ, to just say even once سبحان الله ولو بتهليلة واحدة, to even be able to say once لا إله إلا الله. فلا يؤذن لهم, and they will never be given this chance. حتى إذا جاء أحدهم الموت قال رب ارجعون لعلي أعمل صالحا فيما تركت كلا إنها كلمة هو قائلها وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِمْ بَرْزَخٌ إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ, until when death comes to one of them, he says, my Lord, send me back so that I may do good in that which I have left behind. And the answer will be no. It is but a word that he speaks, and behind them is a barrier until the day when they will be resurrected. هذا هو حال المقصر مع الله. This is the situation of a person that fell short of the expectations of Allah. يقول, he says, لو أن لي كرة فأكون من المحسنين, if only I had another chance, then I should be indeed among the good doers. فالموتى قد انتهت فرصتهم في الحياة, as for the dead, all their chances in this life have been exhausted. وَعَايَنُوا الْآخِرَةِ, and they have seen the hereafter. وَعَرَفُوا مَا لَهُمْ وَمَا عَلَيْهِمْ, and they now know what is in their favor and what is against them. أَدْرَكُوا أَنَّهُمْ, and now they have realized. أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُضَيِّعُونَ أَوْقَاتَهُمْ فِيمَا لَمْ يَكُنْ يَنْفَعُهُمْ فِي آخِرَتِهِمْ, that they were wasting their time in things that would not benefit them in their hereafter. أَدْرَكُوا أَنَّ الْوَقْتَ الَّذِي ضَاعَ مِنْ بَيْنِ أَيْدِيهِمْ لَا يُقَدَّرُ بِثَمَنٍ, that the time which they wasted in this life, it is now priceless. أَدْرَكُوا أَنَّهُمْ كَانُوا فِي نِعْمَةٍ لَمْ يَسْتَغِلُّوهَا, they realize that they had a chance that they never utilized. وَأَصْبَحُوا يَتَمَنَّوْنَ عَمَلَ حَسَنَةٍ وَاحِدَةٍ لَعَلَّهَا تُثَقِّلُ مِيزَانَهُمْ فَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُونَ, and now they wish even for one good deed that would add to their scale of good deeds, but they'll never be able to do that. إِنَّ أَكْثَرَ مَا يَكُونُ الْإِنسَانِ, إن أكثر ما يكون الإنسان غفلة عن نعم الله حينما يكون مغمورا بتلك النعم. When a human being is most heedless, does not pay attention to the bounties of Allah, is when they have it in plenty, is when they are immersed in those bounties and favors. لا يعرف فضلها إلا بعد زوالها. They do not know the value of those bounties of Allah until after they have been taken away. فنحن معشر الأحياء. We, the people who are still alive, في أكبر نعمة. We are in one of the greatest bounties and favors of Allah. طالما أن أرواحنا في أجسادنا. For as long as our soul is inside the body, لنستكثر من ذكر الله وطاعته. That we may remember Allah in plenty. That we may be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. سبحانه وتعالى. ألم تعلم, did you not know my brother, my sister, بأن رسولنا صلى الله عليه وسلم أمرنا عند الاستيقاظ من النوم. He taught us that when we wake up from our sleep, أن نحمد الله تعالى, that we be grateful to Allah, لأنه أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وأذلنا لنا بذكره, that he gave us back life after we were dead, and he permitted us to mention his name. قال, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إذا استيقظ أحدكم, if one of you wakes up, فليقل, let him say, الحمد لله الذي رد علي روحي, all praise is due to Allah who restored back my life, وعافاني في جسدي, and he gave me back my health, وأذن لي بذكره, and he permitted me to mention his name. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم, ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من المواعظ والآيات والذكر الحكيم. أقول ما تسمعون, وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه يا طوبى للمستغفرين. الحمد لله على إنعامه, والشكر له على تفضله وامتنانه, ولا إله إلا الله تعظيما لشأنه, وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على خير خلقه محمد. قال إبراهيم بن يزيد العبدي, this is one of the early predecessors, one of the early Muslims, إبراهيم بن يزيد العبدي, he says, أتاني رياح القيسي, that one day a man by the name رياح القيسي came to him. فقال يا أبا إسحاق, رياح says to إبراهيم, أو أبو إسحاق, انطلق بنا إلى أهل الآخرة نحدث بقربهم عهدا, let us go and visit the people of the hereafter so that we can renew our promise to Allah. فانطلقت معه فأتى المقابر, he says, I went to him. Ibrahim says, I went with Riyah to the graves, to the cemetery. فجلسنا إلى بعض تلك القبور, so we sat next to one of the graves. فقال يا أبا إسحاق, رياح القيسي says to his friend Ibrahim, أو أبو إسحاق, ما ترى هذا متمنيا لو من, what do you think this person inside this grave would wish for if Allah gave them their wish? قلت, إبراهيم says to his friend, أن يرد إلى الدنيا فيستمتع من طاعة الله ويصلح, by Allah his only wish would be to come back to this life and fix the things that he destroyed and to be obedient to Allah. فقال, so رياح says to his friend إبراهيم, ها نحن في الدنيا, you and me, we're still in this dunya, فلنطع الله ولنصلح, let us be obedient to Allah and let us fix what we have destroyed. ثم نهض, then رياح القيسي, he stood up, فجد واجتهد, and he put more effort, فلم يلبث إلا يسيرا حتى مات رحمه الله. A few days afterwards, he died. May Allah have mercy on him. فيا عباد الله, نحن في دار العمل. We are in this abode. We're able to do. والآخرة دار الجزاء. As for the hereafter, that is where we get paid. فمن لم يعمل هنا ندم هناك. The one who does not do what is required here will regret in that life. وكل يوم تعيشه هو غنيمة. And every single day that you live, it is a big favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذا هممت بمعصية تذكر أمان الموتى. When yourself incites you to commit sin, to disobey Allah, remember the wish of the dead people. تذكر أنهم يتمنون لو عاشوا ليطيعوا الله فكيف أنت تعصي الله. Remember the wish of those ones who have died. Their wish is to come back to this life and be obedient to Allah. How dare you misuse this opportunity to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إذا رأيت نفسك فارغا. If you see yourself, you're free, you have nothing to do. فتذكر أمنية الموتى. Remember the wishes of the dead. إذا فترت عن طاعة فاذكر أمنية الموتى. When you are tired and you don't feel like doing anything good, and your good deeds, it died with Ramadan, remember the wishes of the dead people. إِنَّ الَّذِي يُضَيِّعُ وَقْتَهُ. Verily the one who wastes his time, لَوْ يَعْلَمْ مَا يَتَمَنَّ الْمَوْتَى لَمَا ضَيَّعَ دَقِيقَةً وَاحِدَةً. If you knew what the dead people wish for, you would not waste a single minute. ابن القيم رحمه الله تعالى, he says, هلكت جارية في طاعون فرآها أبوها في المنام. There was an epidemic during the time that this Imam lived, just like we had an epidemic a few years ago. There was an epidemic of cholera, and so a young woman died in that epidemic. فرآها أبوها في المنام. After some time, her father saw her in a dream. فقال لها, so he said to his daughter in the dream, يا بنيتي أخبريني عن الآخرة. Oh my daughter, tell me about the hereafter. فقالت, so she said, قدمنا على أمر عظيم. We have come across something that is not easy. وكنا نعلم ولا نعمل. We know about this, but we did nothing. والله لتسبيحة واحدة أو ركعة واحدة في صحيفة عملي أحب إلي من الدنيا وما فيها. She says to her father, by Allah, one تسبيح, one ركعة that I can add to my deeds, it is more beloved to me than the whole world and what it contains. My brothers and sisters, just now as I came inside the masjid, I saw these two janazas lying outside here. Two janazas. هؤلاء من أهل الآخرة. These are from the people of the hereafter. فقد قال الإمام ابن كثير, إمام ابن كثير, he said, من مات فقد قامت قيامته. When a person dies, his hereafter has begun. What you see outside here, they can never be able to realize their wishes. They cannot listen to this khutbah. They cannot pray Salatul Jum'ah. And after Jum'ah is over, they cannot pray Salatul Janazah. They cannot make even a single tasbih. And they cannot pray the sunnah that comes after this prayer. They cannot. It is finished for them. No more chances. But you and me, when salah is over, we will still leave the masjid in a hurry. We don't even have time for those two rak'ah. بِاسْتِعْجَالِ. We're almost crushing each other as we leave the gates of the masjid. You just pray janazah for people who if they had a chance like you, they would pray those two rak'ah. And you are in a hurry to leave the masjid. Likewise, before I came to give the khutbah, I received a phone call from a brother. And yet again, another reminder, just before I got off the car, to come inside the masjid. There's a brother who prayed with us Taraweeh in Ramadan. وَوَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ رَأَيْتُهُ بِأُمِّ عَيْنِي. I saw this beautiful brother in this masjid when he was coming for Salatul Taraweeh. I saw him several times. Brother Muhammad Sharif. This brother was with us towards the end of Ramadan. Then he went for Umrah. He went for Umrah, performed his Umrah. He came to the airport in Jeddah and he was about to take a flight back home, but he collapsed. He's now in a hospital in Jeddah, in a coma. Nothing is moving from his heart except his heart. With a blood clot in his brain, both his lungs have collapsed, they're not functioning, and he's now lying in the ICU in the hospital. كَانَ مَعْنَا فِي رَمَضَانِ. He was with us in this masjid in Ramadan. And a few years ago, Allah tested this brother with a severe test. He lost his only child. His only child that Allah had given him after 7 years of marriage, an 11-year-old daughter. And now this brother, may Allah Azza wa Jalla cure him. Say Ameen. نسأل الله العظيم بأسمائه الحسنى وصفاته العليا أن يشفي أخانا محمد شريف. May Allah cure this brother. May Allah bring him back to his family. May Allah make it easy for him to conquer and overcome the sickness. Such is life, my brothers. When you have this good health, when you're able to walk, you come to the masjid, you pray, and Allah gives you another chance, you travel, you go for Umrah, you have to be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must always say, Rabbi awzi'ni an ashkura ni'mataka allati an'amta alayya. Oh Allah, enable me to show gratefulness. It is not gratefulness that as soon as Ramadan is over, you go back to your evil ways, that you give your back to Allah, who gave you a full Ramadan, and he denied many others, and he gave you that chance. And now when the chance is over, you disrespect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by committing sins. I wish to remind you what Imam Hassan al-Basri says, مَنْ لَمْ يَتَأَدَّبْ مَعَ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ الْأَرْضِ. Whoever is not respectful with Allah on the face of this earth, أَدَّبَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى فِي بَاطِنِ الْأَرْضِ. Allah will teach him a lesson in the belly of this earth. If you disrespect Allah as you walk on this earth, when you go inside there, Allah will teach you a lesson you will never forget. So do not disrespect Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. مَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ رَمَضَانَ فَإِنَّ رَمَضَانَ قَدْ وَلَّ. Whoever is worshipping Ramadan, Ramadan is gone. وَمَنْ كَانَ يَعْبُدُ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ حَيٌّ لَا يَمُوتُ. Whoever is worshipping Allah should know Allah never dies. Allah never ends. وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. You only stop worshipping Allah when you die. Just like the beautiful Egyptian Qari, you've seen in the social media, that blind man that recites the Quran in a very beautiful voice, that moves people to tears with his powerful recitation, Muhammad Kamil. The brother, every Ramadan, he's invited to different masajid in America. This year he was invited to Masjid Tawheed in New Jersey. And yesterday, after he finished Ramadan and he led the people in Taraweeh, this beautiful brother, he passed away and he went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was only 38 years old. This Qari, Muhammad Kamil, was only 38 years old. وَقَدْ أَفْضَى إِلَى مَا قَدَّمَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. And now he will see with Allah what he put forward for his journey. We're on a journey, يا إخوة الإيمان, whether we like it or not. And every day of this journey, it takes us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So let us prepare for this journey before you're taken away when you least expect it. عباد الله, إن الله أمركم بأمر بدأ فيه بنفسه وثن به ملائكته المسبحة بقدسه فقال عز من قائل عليم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وزد وأنعم وبارك على عبدك وخليلك محمد وعلى آله وصحابته أجمعين اللهم اغفر لجميع المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم فرج هم المهمومين ونفس كرب المكروبين واقض الدين عن المدينين واشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم اشف مرضانا ومرضى المسلمين اللهم وارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين اللهم ثبتنا حتى نلقاك اللهم يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك اللهم يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا على طاعتك اللهم ارزقنا حسن الخاتمة اللهم ارزقنا حسن الخاتمة اللهم اجعل خير أيامنا يوم نلقاك وأنت راض عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم